The Seven Last Words of Christ, excerpts from the Mystical Vine by St. Bonaventure. Seven words, like seven leaves evergreen, come forth from our vine aloft on the cross. Your spouse has become a harp, the wood of the cross being the frame, and his body extended on the wood, representing the strings. And these are the seven words. First, while he was being nailed to the cross, the most loving Jesus says, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they are doing." The good teacher follows his own teaching. He prays not only for his friends, but also for those who persecute him. Hide this leaf within the treasury of your heart, so that whatever enemies attack you, you may recall the abounding sweetness of the good Jesus, and always use this world as a shield against their insults. Your spouse prays for those who are killing him. Can you not pray for those who are merely speaking evil of you? Jesus is saying, "In the name of your love, by which we are one, I beg you, Father, to accept my love and forgive my enemies." The second leaf of our vine and the second string of our harp is the word that our Lord addressed to the thief who acknowledged him and sought to be with him. "Amen," Jesus said, "I say to you, this day you shall be with me in paradise." How quickly has an enemy been changed into a friend? A stranger into a member of the household, an alien into a close relative, a sinner into a confessor. How great is the thief's confidence. He knows that everything in him is malice and nothing good, that he has broken the law, taking without conscience both the goods and livelihood of his neighbor. Now, in his last hour, on the threshold of death, despairing of this present life, he yet dares to seek reassurance in the hope of the future life, which he has forfeited again and again, and has never deserved. Who could despair when this thief still hopes? Jesus is an attentive listener, an instant promiser, a swift giver. The third leaf and third chord of the harp is the third saying of Jesus. Woman, behold thy son, and behold thy mother. Besides his own suffering on the cross, how great a share of his mother's suffering must he have borne? For he knew well that now the sword of bitter sorrow is piercing her gentle heart. If Mary did not faint in this agony, it is because her son inwardly sustained her and outwardly consoled her by his consoling word and action. How generous you are at your wedding, O King and spouse! How generously, O good Jesus, you have given away all your belongings. For even to the crucifiers, you have offered the kindness of prayers. To the thief, you have given paradise. To the mother, a son. To the son, a mother. To the dead, life. Into the hands of your Father, your Spirit, to the whole world, the signs of your power, and to the earth, through your gaping wounds, not a measure, but the whole of your body and blood.
Thank you.
The fourth leaf and the fourth string of the harp is the fourth word of Jesus. At about the ninth hour, he cried out with a loud voice, "Eli, Eli, lema sabachthani?" That is, my God, why have you forsaken me?" How deep must have been the cruel pain of Jesus as these words rang out from his tortured body. Even though Jesus kept his courage throughout his passion, he also revealed the depth of his torment. In order to show his profound communion with the church, his bride, and his love for us, he makes it clear that he suffers in all the members of the church. When his followers suffer, even to the point of feeling abandoned by God, Jesus himself suffers through us, with us, and in us.
Thank you.
the fifth leaf and the fifth string of the harp is the fifth word the most loving Jesus uttered on the cross, saying, I thirst. Whereupon they have him wine mixed with myrrh and gall to drink. Through the words, I thirst, Jesus wants to express the immensity of his love. For a thirsty man craves for drink much more desperately than a hungry man craves for food, indicating to us by this thirst the intensity of desire for a thing most ardently sought. Christ gives us a demonstration of his burning love for us. He thirsts with the most intense desire for our salvation. The sixth leaf and the sixth string of the harp is the sixth word which Jesus, the true and supreme sweetness, uttered after taking the bitter wine. It is finished. Jesus, with patient perseverance and courage, bears to the end his cruel passion for our sins, and everything foretold in the Old Testament has been fulfilled. So, we too, if we would be members of the church, must persevere in the face of all our troubles until, following our guide, Jesus, most kind, we reach the end of all our tribulations and can say confidently with him, "It is finished." By your help, dear Father, not by my own strength, I have fought the good fight. I have finished the course. I have kept the faith. Perseverance is what makes a good work endure. The seventh and final leaf of our vine and seventh string of the harp is the final word of our most loving Jesus. Father, into your hands I commend my spirit. Even though Jesus is in eternal communion with the Father, he expresses his trust in God's providential care by lifting up his spirit to the Father. Jesus knows that everything he is, body, soul, and spirit, belongs to the Father. And now, at the point of death, he gives everything back to the Father. Jesus always empties himself, even taking the nature of a slave. Planted in our earth, he accepted the limitations and vulnerability of our human body and bore leaves, flowers, and much fruit in order that, as he had been united to our humanity, so he might unite us to his divinity. If you've gotten anything at all out of following Christ, St. Paul says, if his love has made any difference in your life, if being in a community of the Spirit means anything to you, if you have a heart, if you care, then do me a favor. Agree with each other. Love each other. Be deep-spirited friends. Don't push your way to the top. Don't sweet-talk your way to the front. Put yourself aside and help others get ahead. Don't be obsessed with getting your own advantage. Forget yourselves long enough to lend a helping hand. Think of yourselves the way Christ Jesus thought of himself. He had equal status with God, but didn't think so much of himself that he had to cling to the advantages of that status no matter what. Not at all. When the time came, he set aside the privileges of deity and took on the status of a slave, became human. Having become human, he stayed human. It was an incredibly humbling process. He didn't claim special privileges. Instead, he lived a selfless, obedient life and then died a selfless, obedient death. And the worst kind of death at that, a crucifixion. Because of that obedience, God lifted him high and honored him far beyond anyone or anything ever, so that all created beings in heaven and on earth, even those long ago dead and buried, will bow and worship before this Jesus Christ and call out in praise that he is the master of all, to the glory of God the Father. Amen. May God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.